Thought I told you whores to get the fuck out of here. You thought I told you to fucking get the fuck out of here too.
God.
That's a shame. I really liked him. Call him.
Anthony.
Well, how's it going?
Pretty good. What are you up to?
Just sitting around drinking by myself.
Oh, well, Vic's out of town if you're not up to anything.
Well, no, I think that sounds pretty good. I'll come right over. All right. Woo!
Thank you.
You knew this day would come.
No, baby, no.
Did it again. Caused trouble. Hurt someone's feelings. Yet he didn't want to do it. Yes, troublesome people are often people in trouble. They may be mentally ill. Find out how you can help. Write Better Mental Health, Box 3000, New York 1, New York.
Yeah. A governor's task force has determined that punk rockers are society's new subversives and must be treated as such. Wayne Friedman reports from San Francisco.
Are you a good person or a bad person?
I'm a great person. I'm a great person.
She may know it, her friends may know it, but the governor's task force disagrees.
Hi, Mr. Duke Majin!
A new report names punk rockers, heavy metalers, and satanic groups the new violent youth gangs in California. It says they hold nothing sacred.
Well, let's go over to the...
You ready to drink, faggot?
That's Mr. Faggot.
Shut up, fucker!
Yeah, shut up. God damn it, Ryan! I was just fucking choking, man!
Faggot.
Presumed to have topless Vinnie Jones? What? No way.
Like, there's so much crazy shit going on, and people are fucking dying and shit. Like, seriously.
What the fuck is going on, Vinny?
I'll explain it in a second. We can lock the fucking door. Oh my god, fucking sis, you gotta fucking believe me. All fucking hell is breaking loose. Like, you gotta fucking help me. You have to fucking help me.
What the fuck did you do, Vinny?
I didn't do shit, man. I fucking, dude, all this crazy shit is going on, I swear to god. Like, this fucking crazy hobo came out of the woodwork, like, some fucking... The other guy, I don't even know who the fuck
he
is.
Yeah, some other guy, shithead. Why is your name in a fucking journal?
What, my name's in the fucking journal?
It's in a journal. You're listed as an accomplice.
No, I swear to God.
What the fuck did you do?
I fucking swear to God, I didn't fucking kill those people. I didn't fucking kill anybody. You gotta fucking believe me, sissy, I swear. God, I didn't fucking kill those fucking people.
Get the fuck out of here. Get off me, son of a bitch.
God damn it. You gotta fucking believe me, I swear to fucking god. Oh, fuck!
Think we can get any booze money out of this piece of shit?
I'll sure as fuck try.
From guys.
Really?
Jesus. Oh, whatever. Had it your way, but don't expect the Burger King treatment, bitch. Motherfucker never had pitch anyways. Dead weight, fuck.
Come on, shithead.
Oh, what the fuck is up, slut? Are we going to the party or what?
Get your panties in a wad, faggot. Music's gonna be so loud, nobody's gonna hear dips in the trunk. Besides, substations don't close.
Oh yeah, what does that mean?
Means you get to rub your dick with the other faggots at your precious little party.
Sounds like fun.
fun.
Oh, fuck. We're getting pulled over.
Are we really?
Yes.
Alright, let's kick this shit in first.
Yeah!
Woo!
This next song is called Crucify Us All.
It's gonna get dark in here. Hit it.
Tell me, who fucking hates normal people?
Real quick before everybody exits the room, the keg is here.
I am.
Fucking dead people.
It won't leave us alone.
Damn it.
Why is partying outside? It's fucking cold.
I don't know, man. It's because there's a mountain of fucking corpses inside.
Oh,
that's why.
Like usual.
Yeah. Dude, it never ends, man. They just keep kind of piling up. Hey, I call it. Oh, fuck.
My cigarette. Keep it up, buddy.
No. Wait. Here you go. I think that might be. Bring a lot of blood around here.
Ketchup. Eat it.
I don't know if it is blood. I don't know. No.
fuck!
Wait the fuck off, motherfucker! You're gonna tell us right the fuck now what's going on!
Fuck, you came to the wrong house!
This punk party petered out on Brittany.
Yes.
Four fewer punks in the world. Such a pity. What you think? Suicide?
Just because of the one grave?
Yeah.
Maybe. You know, but... You know, suicide's in these days with the young kids. But I'm not ruling anything out. Just, that doesn't really add up to me right now.
Why do you say that?
Well, I mean... The first one, he got shot in the head. Gunshot wound to the face. I mean, you know, if I was gonna go, that'd be, you know, the normal way to do it, right?
Sure.
But this lady here, the girl, her tongue is pulled out. That's kind of a weird way to commit suicide. I mean, I don't know if I'd go out that way. Honestly, somebody else would have to pull that out for her. I don't think she did it herself. This third guy here, you can tell his head was smashed in because, you know, somebody's bare hands because of the dried blood around his ears and then around his eyes as well. See right there? This fourth guy, he got like the frontal lobe smashed, like the iron claw. Like somebody just crushed his head. He has traumatic head injury to the frontal lobe.
Yeah, that's like a high botched lobotomy.
That's what I'm talking about. But you know, our forensic team will be able to let us know if it was a blunt instrument or a sharp instrument. Well, kind of like the shovel over there. It's got dry blood on it.
Right. Well, how about this? Why didn't this guy with the gunshot wound, he killed everybody, and then he offed himself at the end?
Okay. That's where's the gun? We haven't had a gun on the crime scene yet.
Right. Yeah, that should be here.
I mean, and it's, why not, I don't know, even do a drug overdose with some, because there's a ton of needles and all kinds of shit. I mean, look at all that over the place. You know, I mean, it'd be less traumatic to the body.
An easier way to go.
Right. Easier, I mean, we couldn't really trace it. It's not like they, you know, it's far-fetched that these punks would do something like that. You know, less, you know, it's harder to trace.
Right. I guess I didn't think about that.
All right, well, what next, Junior?
Why don't we go check the car? See if we can get some blood samples.
All right, help me bag this shovel. Let's make that happen. Step. What's with the APD? What's with the crime scene here? You guys gonna use a chair? Fucking amateurs, man. Stop. Watch your step. Watch your step, man. Get your gloves. Get your gloves. Right,
I have no gloves.
Of course you don't. Come on, Hab.
I'm coming.
Be careful back there, Hab.
Fuck it! Christ!
Fucking you, dude.
Yeah, it's just me.
Oh my god, at least you're not trying to fucking kill me, dude.
I mean, that could be arranged.
Nah, man, you won't even believe the fucking time I'm having, dude.
Had a pretty rough day of it, huh?
Oh my god, fucking, some fucking doctor's trying to frame me.
Oh?
There's like this crazy fucking bomb killing everybody.
I mean, I don't know anything about that doctor, but All right. Just chill, man. Just chill, dude. Let's have a seat here, and I'll tell you what I know about this bum. Cause I know what bum you're fucking talking about, dude. And there's a lot of rumors flying around about this guy. One, some people say that he's got like fucking rabies, like he got bit by a rabid badger. But the people that say that before that happened, he fell into some toxic goo and shit and has never been the same, like some kind of radioactive shit from Los Alamos or something, dude. And then like, I mean, I don't know. I've heard he was in Nam too and he's never been the same since, you know? Like people say he has PTSD and just like snaps sometimes and just, you know, but, and the other thing I've heard, I mean, some people even go as far as saying he's like an alien or some shit, you know? Like, dude, I mean, there's a lot of people talking about this guy because he's causing a lot of attention around here and not the right kind of attention. You know what I mean? He's like, it's fucking crazy, dude. I know which guy you're talking about, and like everybody has their theories, but no one really knows why he is the way he is. We just know that he's fucking going nuts, like, you know? And that's about all I know. I mean, I would think probably the Nam story is true. That's one of the more believable ones, you know? But
no, I know you're full of shit. Your inner child isn't fucking potty trained.
Yeah, well, that may be true, but don't kill my messenger, man. I'm just telling you what I hear. For some reason, people like to tell me everything they know. I don't know what it is.
Thanks, bro.
Yeah, no worries.
It's fucking something.
Yeah, it's good to see you're still alive, man.
You too.
Yeah.
Every single time, why does this stupid shit happen when we're on duty? I mean, we're supposed to be out solving bigger crimes, doing bigger things, and the brass doesn't see what we're doing.
You're absolutely
right. The admin doesn't see. Am I right?
You're absolutely right. I don't get it. They obviously don't know what they're doing. They should be putting us on some Sherlock Holmes kind of cases, you know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm talking about. Right.
I don't know, man. This is getting to be, I'm thinking I gotta quit, man. I'm serious.
Hold on, Dr. Watson. You're my partner. You have a wife and kids. So do I. You're not going anywhere. I'm not going to let you quit. So just quit talking about shit, okay?
All right. I'm just, you know, I'm a little upset. You know, I wish that they would put us on cases like that teacher with the occult shit.
Right.
It's fucking crazy.
You know, they're rotting in prison right now. That's, you know, I love that. I love that. You got to get up pretty early in the morning if you want to get one past me, if I do say so myself.
Yeah, I gotta say, you did handle your business, and, you know, I like to think that I might have had a little something to do with that myself.
Oh, no doubt, man. You know you did your thing, Hab, right? That's what I'm talking about. Well, hey, we have a job at hand, so let's get to work on this one here, okay?
Right.
All right. Roll this dude over, man. Do it with your foot. Just do it with your foot. Don't touch him.
Oh.
Oh,
fuck.
Ooh, ouch. Look at that, his eye. Oh, man. We'll get some blood samples and bag that stick, Ab.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I can't do it.
Let me reach down here and get this thing. Here we go. Hello. I'm gonna go canvas the neighborhood. We'll see if there's any eyewitnesses. Okay? Come on. Let's get your shit together, okay? Here, bag this. Let's go. Come on.
I can't do it.
Look. Listen up, man. This could be a Breaking Bad moment. Stop being a punk pussy bitch, bag the stick, and let's do this. It's time to shine, baby.
bag to stick. I'm gonna go into canvas the neighborhood and get some eyewitnesses. Let's do this, all right? Let's roll. Fuck it.
Slow down, honey. I know you're that self-loathing punk picking off gutter punks.
What? What are you talking about?
You have to explain to me. I kind of dig it. But my roommate's going to be home soon, so you should probably clean yourself up.
You have a shower?
Yeah. Let me show you where it is. Partying, and I come back and my roommates are dead.
They pay half the rent. What am I gonna do for rent? I just can't believe this freaking happened to me.
This is happening to you?
Yeah.
What about your roommate, Susie? Looks like you're kind of making off a little better than she is, right? What's your name, ma'am?
Melissa Baker. I'm one's twin sister.
Okay, Miss Baker, where's the other body?
What, you think I did it? I murdered her? I didn't freaking murder her.
Miss Baker, calm down.
Yeah, there's nobody saying that you kill anybody. Let's just calm down at the moment, okay?
Ma'am, can we take a look at the rest of the house?
Yeah. Go ahead. I mean, I just called you guys as soon as I got here.
You don't know if there's anybody else in here?
I assumed they weren't.
Oh, it's clearly a perfect. Let's go.
Open the door.
Police.
That's who our suspect and murderer is.
Man.
Yeah,
let's go.
Let's do it.
I didn't fucking kill my roommate.
Nobody said you did, ma'am. Okay. Calm down already.
What? I'm just saying.
Please relax. We have more information on the case.
Excellent. Let's do it, ma'am. Let's go.
If you guys are going to try to say that I murdered them, then that's just ridiculous, because I didn't freaking murder them. I just got back from vacation.
Please, calm down. We have...
I just can't believe this is fucking happening to me. I mean, I have fucking rent to pay. They paid half the rent. What am I supposed to fucking do?
Ma'am, I would suggest you contact the station and see if you can see any counselors. Been bent.
Yeah.
Okay. All right,
well, thank you for your cooperation, ma'am. We will be in touch, okay? Thank you.
Most gruesome crime scene to yet to date for this guy. I don't know how much more I can take of this.
I'm done.
I suggest we catch this asshole before this stops. If it gets any worse. I don't see how that's gonna happen.
Oh, fuck it.
Oh my god.
All right.
Bag this, man. Bag some stuff up. Let's get some evidence. Oh dear lord. Oh my god. Hold on. It's headquarters. Okay. Yeah. Uh-huh. There was an eyewitness that said there was a tranny that was running away from this crime scene about 10 minutes ago. Size 15 pumps.
All right. What do we do now?
Let's hurry up, bag this. Call it in, and let's get on the trail of the tranny, man. Let's make it happen. Let's do it.
This trail leads somewhere good.
All right. Hey, wait. What is that? Is that a dart? What's a dart doing in this hood?
I don't think anybody's going to be playing darts around here.
These kids around in this hood, they play with guns. Real guns. Well, let's bag that. Get it to the lab, Hap. All right, let's make it happen, baby.
Got it.
Bag that dick, Haberle.
I fucking love my job. Right? Barehanded, too.
God bless.
Hey! Change! You took my change!
What the fuck happened to your face?
Yeah, my face. What happened to my face? What happened to my face? You're in hell now, punk.
No, really, man, who the fuck are you?
Who the fuck am I?
Yeah!
You little punk so perpetually drunk.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll just start at the beginning. Maybe that'll jog your memory.
Alright, see you later, Doc.
Sick today, Vinny? Nice. Oh, hey, Vinny. That little punk rock cock ready for me? I'm gonna take your temperature.
So what's up, Doc?
I might ask you the same question. You appear to be in perfect physical condition. Peak, even. You know what I'm saying?
I guess so, Doc.
You ready for your checkup?
Hey, I'll tell you what, Doc. You got 20 bones. I'll let you eat some tube steak.
Pocket change, my boy.
Yeah, fuck yeah. Yeah, what a fig.
Wait a second. You're that fucking faggot doctor?
Faggot?
Whoa.
No, man.
And now you don't.
No! No!
Joker! Can you fucking piss off me or my fucking friends?
Oh my god!
Fucking damn it!
The fuck did we just walk into?
I seriously need to quit.
Cut that shit out, man. This is Officer Dixon. I'm at 3129 Elm Street. I'm requesting backup. I've shot a perpetrator in mid-assault. 3129 Elm Street, requesting backup. Double time, now! Holy shit, Haverly, this is crazy shit. You were asking for this earlier today, huh? You wanted to quit? Huh? We get all the big cases, man. This is how we do it. Whew, yeah. Some crazy shit. That's how we do it. China store.
I fucking hate these tapes.
ABC, man. Fucking dummies.
Well, they could make a little room for somebody to walk through. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, a little more room.
I do like my kicks.
Right. Oh, I love me a bear claw, right? They even know something going on. Yeah. Donuts. That's a cop crack.
Gonna have to get some of those, celebrate after all this shit.
Oh, no kidding, man.
The face of the modern punk. An ugly face to some, but what an eloquent and creative group of individuals they are. What they lack in grey matter between the ears, they make up for in colour on top.
Please don't leave me alone!
Who gave their lives for something never
on? There's nothing quite like a sing-song at home, or a poetry recitation.
It's happening again.
Go on, it's my birthday.
I'm 19 today!
Birthday, John!
Yeah, lighter.
And this is a side to punkdom you won't have seen before.
You have to pay. Right.
Unless you've wandered up London's King's Road.
Do you want to come down and take some photographs? As many as you want to take for £2.
If you want any photographs, you have to pay.
These punks are business punks, ripping money out of the tourists faster than you can say, get nicked.
Come on, think about
not that
it.
Bad of a trip.
Their enterprising 24-year-old leader with the Aussie ostrich haircut is Alex.
Yeah, right. How's business this morning?
Pretty good. I made about 12, 13 quid, and that was without not having any arguments with anyone. That's pretty much a strike.
If you don't get your head kicked in.
Sometimes Alex has to educate other members of the gang. Here, he's requesting an apprentice punk to be more respectful.
I told you again to if you're going to cause trouble.
After a hard day's work, it's time to go home. In their case, home for all 20 in the gang is a condemned house in Islington. They had to break in to get possession, but what a flair for interior decoration they've shown.
What about parents? How do your parents react?
My dad loves me. At first they think, you know, is it something I've done? Is it anything, you know, have I raised you wrong? Have I done something against you or anything like that, you know? And you say no, it's just, you know, you've got to prove what you feel.
I'm going to skew with my bottle.
Just about any type of drug is in, but glue sniffing ranks equal number one with cheap booze.
Hello!
Cyril is a glue man, and his outlook on life is invariably through a plastic bag. Even on the street, he has something up his sleeve to make work more tolerable.
the only thing that no one takes is heroin, you know, if I do, we kick them out. That's the thing that is really, really bad for you. Most people take things in moderation, you know.
There are only two rules in this house. No heroin and no glue sniffing upstairs. In this room, 10 punks bed down for the night. With names like Bumbox, Scumbag and Animal, you can imagine the very special aroma in here. But the cosy sleeping arrangements seem to have some advantages in their eyes.
Now, what about sex?
Please,
don't get enough of it.
Alex,
what
about
enough? I can't get enough.
You've got 20 men and women living fairly closely together in a fairly small place.
We never have sex.
Do you have a fairly free lifestyle as far as sex goes?
No.
We're not queer, that's for sure.
Fairly free, yeah.
Like so many home-loving folk, punks love pets. They have a cat and a ready supply of cat food.
It's never bit me at all, never.
It's hard to know who stands a greater chance of contracting an infectious disease, the punks or the rats.
Excuse me, if you want a photograph, you have to pay.
What'd you say?
You have to pay for photographs.
Oh, we have to pay?
See what, how much? £2. As many as you want.
Come on, you can take as many as you want for a couple of pounds.
No, I don't take any of that.
I'm taking pictures of the building here.
No, you're not.
We're not stupid. You think we're thick?
Being a punk can get even the grubbiest of individuals down, and some of these punks show evidence of trying to swap their mohawk haircuts for halos. The police arrived for a bit of healthy harassment. Were they looking for a secret stock of glue or evidence of an orgy? Had they come to evict the lot of them and save the neighbourhood?
Alien, what's going on?
The neighbours went into deep gossip.
Have you got permission to talk to him?
No. But the police only wanted to find out what could possibly interest an Australian TV crew in a group of grubbies like this.
What a rude person!
I take drugs and get